This is Yorkshire Television in colour.
Hello, campers. This is Radio Marklin. Well, we've got a fun-packed programme for you this afternoon.
By magic, the shopkeeper appeared. What exactly are you looking for? The shopkeeper asked Mr. Ben. Mr. Ben looked confused. I'm going to a party, and the invitation says, dress smart. So I mustn't look too dull. I think I know what this calls for, said the shopkeeper. Mr. Ben looked very smart indeed. Mr. Ben couldn't help looking at the other door, the door that always leads to adventures. I wonder what adventure lies through there today, he thought. And open the door.
One, two, oh, one, two, three, two. Who lives in a pineapple under the sea?
SquidBob SquarePants!
Absorbent and yellow and porous is he?
SquidBob SquarePants!
If nautical nonsense be something you wish,
SquidBob SquarePants!
Then drop on the deck and flop like a fish!
SquidBob SquarePants!
Ready? SquidBob SquarePants! SquidBob SquarePants! SquidBob SquarePants! SpongeBob SquarePants!
Calling Orson. Come in, Orson. I don't know how much value I have in this universe, but I do know that I made a few people happier than they would have been without me, as long as I know that. Nanu! Nanu!
This is Yorkshire Television in colour.
Hello, campers. This is Radio Marklin. Well, we've got a fun-packed programme for you this afternoon.
By magic, the shopkeeper appeared. What exactly are you looking for? The shopkeeper asked Mr. Ben. Mr. Ben looked confused. I'm going to a party, and the invitation says, dress smart. So I mustn't look too dull. I think I know what this calls for, said the shopkeeper. Mr. Ben looked very smart indeed. Mr. Ben couldn't help looking at the other door, the door that always leads to adventures. I wonder what adventure lies through there today, he thought, and opened the door.
Universe, but I do know that I made a few people happier than they would have been without me, as long as I know that. Nanu! Nanu!
For bed. Come on. I'll pack you in a little bit. Oh, hi. Welcome. You're just in time for the party. Would you like a cheese puff?
Hello. I'm sorry to bother you, but I'm having a dinner party and I seem to run out of coffee.
You can be anything you want to be there.
You can see.
There's excitement in the air for you and me there. Fancy free there, take your family there. But you've got to be there.
Yeah.
You just got to be there. You'll feel free there. You'll be what you want to be. See what you want to see. Seven holes, the key there. Be there.
Hello, customers. It's nearly 6 o'clock. Pack up and piss off.
Hello.
Hi, good evening.
Hi. Hopefully you can hear us. Welcome to the Wig and Slingback. Now, before we start, a very serious note. In fact, I've written it down because I just want to get this right. Ladies and gentlemen, I come before you today with a very heavy heart and a humble spirit. It's come to my attention that in the whirlwind of excitement of live television, I made a grave oversight in our last broadcast. I failed to acknowledge the indispensable contribution of one individual whose name should have been on the lips of gratitude, but unfortunately slipped through the cracks. I'm referring to none other than the esteemed Timmy Alexis Carrington Ward. Timmy, my friend, I owe you a debt of gratitude that I can never fully repay. It was your keen eye, your unwavering dedication to the pursuit of television excellence that led us to that unforgettable Colleen Nolan clip. And yet, in my haste and in my excitement, I neglected to mention your name, and for that I am truly sorry. Timmy, know that your contribution was not only noted, but cherished. To Timmy Alexis Carrington Ward, I offer my sincerest apologies. Your name should have been uttered with reverence and respect. And for that oversight, I am truly sorry. Rest assured, your name shall never be forgotten again on this show. Thank you for your understanding and your forgiveness. We are only human, prone to error, but in recognising our mistakes, we can strive to be better. And with your continued support, we endeavour to bring you the finest in live television. Alan.
Well, last week, Here She Is wasn't. So, you know, as Jamie said, he's very sorry.
Here she isn't even here tonight after I've printed all that out.
She'll be in the bath or walking dog or supping champagne.
Welcome.
A little bit of fanboy there, darling.
Yeah, I had an angry message the next day on WhatsApp.
So he sent you the clip.
He showed me the Colleen Nolan clips, not that one, but those.
And then you sort of thought you'd take it upon yourself to send it, to sell it as your own.
And I didn't even mention that I met Timmy in London, so I've met him in all his glory.
Timmy, he's ashamed.
Right, loves. There's loads of you in tonight. The YouTube bar was busy before we even arrived.
It was hustling bustling as I was coming up the stairs.
Sherry Sump's been working those pumps like there's no tomorrow.
Working like a donkey.
Let's have a look who's in. Right, obviously it cuts off loads of your first messages. So we are starting with Simon Jones and Pete Potofsky. Welcome.
Simon Jones, you've been gone too long.
Pete Potofsky, Paul McFarlane, good to see you, Paul.
Now, Paul wasn't in last week because he was a star on another podcast about Celtic United football or something.
Is it Celtic or Celtic?
Celtic, I think. So he was a guest. He was a guest appearance.
Guest appearance on a rival.
So we forgive him.
Rival Poddo.
We forgive him for dropping us.
Let's have a look. Mr. Venus is in. Hiya.
Hi.
Tracy 30
Tracy,
is here.
Tracy.
It's Tracy's partner's, Earl's. I think Earl's her partner. 40th birthday next week, so she's planning that at the moment. Lots of talk about Barbara Dixon and her farewell show. I don't know if it's a farewell show, but she's on tour at the moment.
She's been singing for years.
Let's have a look. Jason Darcy is in. Hello, Jason, my lovely. Let's have a look. Who else? Darren Bramley. Darren and Rebecca are in. Hello, my lovelies. Simon Jones wants Scampi Kiev on Croot. Do you think Sherry can do that?
Oh, yeah, she can do that. Back there with a chip pan.
Who else is there? Simon Jones also wants some Monster Munch washed down with mbongo and a little...
Oh, roast beef flavour or pickled onion.
A little Ribena tooth kind. And a can of Quattro, because, of course, it's 1987 tonight.
It is.
Coral Daft is here. She says, hi, everyone. Gosh, I was 28 in 1987. Time flies. Cheers. And she raises her jam shed to us all.
They weren't jam shed back in 1987, were they?
I bet Coral used to mix a red wine with a little bit of Robinson's Preserve.
I remember my mum used to buy drink hampers for Christmas. And the wine used to come with them were, ooh. It was either a German white... Or a
blue nun
French red.
There were wine things, but it weren't really wine shops, were there?
No.
There was just a bit of Safeways.
Yeah. I can't remember wine being all that great back then.
I think mum and dad used to make wine.
Did they?
Or have people make wine for them.
Did they tread the grapes?
Oh, we had people to do that out in the garden. Let's have a look at anyone else. Nibbles and Bubbles are in. Hello, darlings.
Hello, sweethearts.
From Down Road. Archie Diggins is in.
Oh, Archie Diggins.
D'Angela is just saying hi to everyone. She's in her sick bed.
Oh,
so love to D'Angela.
Poor D'Angela.
Gary Donnelly is in. Hello, boys. Hello,
Hello
Gary.
Hello, Gary, darling.
Gary Donnelly. Ooh, Gary Donnelly. Ooh,
Gary Donnelly. On the radio.
1987, BG Bear says that was streaked hair and a perm, but he thinks that might have been 86 or 88, and he was flogging his ice cream on his bike.
I know, we saw the photo this week. Oh, he was an handsome ice cream man, wasn't he?
He was indeed.
I'd have had a little bit of crushed nuts on my little cornetto.
Linda LaHughes is in. Hi, Linda. Lucy, my cousin. Simon Jones. Did we mention Simon Jones?
Simon Jones, you've been gone too long.
Joel Hazeldine is in.
Who's leaving who?
Will Venus ASMR is in.
Hello.
Hello, sweetheart.
I think I did an Irish accent there.
It's all right. He wouldn't mind a little Irish. Running through the names. Gary Donnelly is wondering where Gary Gessle is.
Who's Gary Gessle?
I think Gary Gessle pops up later.
Helen's in.
Helen is in.
Oh,
Helen
funny
from Hull.
Helen.
Oh, dinner lady and all.
She makes me laugh that much at her.
She does.
Very funny.
Paul Esselmont is in. Hiya, Paul. Lots of the Americans aren't in tonight.
Look, something might be going on, like some TV, like about baseball or something.
Pip is in. Shalom, Pip.
Shalom, Pip.
Maybe YouTube's gone down in the Americas.
I always want to clutch my pearls when I say Shalom, Pip, because he always has a little string of pearls on.
I look like I've got a bit of lipstick on tonight. I haven't. It's just this blue light behind us, I think, playing with your eyes. Butterfly Yube is in. Hello from Soggy Swansea.
Oh, soggy, you love.
Rosie Kinman is in from New Zealand.
Rosie Kinman.
She's joining us at Socks Fuss.
We've got Fuss and Chops. We've got Miss Kinman from the VA seeing Cahoon and Ludlow, but they're not in, are they?
They're not in either. Neil Sandwell is in. Hello, Neil, my darling.
Oh, she's over there, is she?
She's in that bar tonight. Gary Gessel is now in, saying evening all. Anyone else? Marcia is in, my lovely sister-in-law, who I saw at the weekend.
Lovely photo, Marcia.
My dad is in. Hello, Dad.
Hello,
and Mum, who I also saw at the weekend.
And
no sign of Cilla's ghost.
No, she's 99, is she?
So we can all summon either Cilla's ghost or maybe the ghost of Thora Heard might appear again.
Lily Law, hello, darling.
Lily Law, it's all just scanned by. Lily Law.
Darren Small.
Dazzle from Brizzle. Alex Johnson. Dale Ibbotson. Caroline Ibbotson. John Morissette. John Hart. Everyone's arrived now. All in one go.
Oh, yeah.
Ross Morgan.
Yeah. Emotional Urban Homestead.
I've said that. Caroline is an S. Hobson. Mally and Steve. Hello, love.
Hello, darlings.
Mally and Steve come to our bingo shows from Hull. Andy Fryer's Junk. 1987, he was 4. Jamie Rees. Hello, Jamie. I think that's about it. I think that's about it.
Colin Neal.
But yeah, no Cilla. So if we can all like think Cilla thoughts, she'll
try and drag her from her crypt.
Who knows? Over on this side of the
world.
There's not many
in this one, I don't think, is there? We've got lovely Joel William Hazeldean with his loose sweet corn. Sarah Simpson.
The Simpsons.
And she's asking after Peggy. Peggy's better. She's still got a bit of a limp when she rests on it, but she's sort of tip-tapping on all her 4 feet now.
She's down there.
Shall I move the camera?
Yeah, oh, there she is.
She's about. She might do a bit of limping. Oh, my leg. But she's getting lots of love. She's on some new pills, isn't she?
Yeah, she is. Recommended by...
some of you, my darlings.
Yeah.
We've also got Mark Monday and Pearson, who's not feeling very well, but sending lots of love. He says that these live shows make him feel a lot better.
Good.
And so love to you and Ricky and the pets. We've got lovely Mark.
Oh, he's tall.
He's tall, isn't he?
Aren't they tall?
Mark and Alex, since you visited us, all our sort of local friends have said, oh, they were tall, weren't they? They were dashing and tall.
It's only because we're so short.
Lovely Perinda, Mr. Perinda, saying hello. And Mr. Ribbons Bobbins Duffer, we saw your little pictures of your little murder mystery that you went on.
Oh, and our receptionist.
Oh, we've got... We're so pleased to have Jason Rigby...
Miss Rigby on reception.
..in the house, because whenever we need any sort of, like, names of programmes or titles or dates, he finds it so quickly. And he reminds us of the receptionist in Ghostbusters. It goes, Ghostbusters! So,
He's not just like a receptionist like Alan Sugar's one who uses a phone a bit weirdly.
And doesn't really talk, because you can go in there.
He works. He's like Mr. Pesco in Moonlighting.
He's in that reception and he doesn't just play Candy Crush or watch old episodes of... Well, he might watch old episodes
and
of
it's,
comedy programmes.
When we ask him to search things, it's not on his phone or on a computer. It's in files, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not...
Filing cabinets.
We're talking 1987.
Rolodex.
It's 1987, so he's got filing cabinets. Loads of TV time stacked up this high. So he's busy.
So we might... Jason, we need to know what was happening in EastEnders and Coronation Street in February 1987.
Or March 1st.
Or March.
We've got Leanne McGee, who's popped... Can you just go up a bit, see if I've not missed anyone? Oh, no, there he is. That's all right. Lovely Melanie. Now, Melanie popped a drink on Facebook today. It was some kind of black cherry drink.
Has it inspired you tonight? You've got a funny drink tonight.
No, I've just got Ooch. Pink Ooch.
Pink Ooch.
So that looked lovely, Melanie, that drink, whatever. Black cherry something. Beth and Williams, hello, sweetheart.
From New South Wales, Australia.
Jay Shaw says hello to everybody. Alexander Bowen.
I used to know someone called Alexander Bowen.
Alexandra Bowen, sorry. Hello, I called you Alexander then. Sorry about that. Jill Barron says greetings. Marilyn Towie.
Marilyn Towie says she's just popped in to ask Jamie after his trip to Liverpool. Don't know if you've seen it, but someone has stuck turkey teeth on Cilla Black's statue in Matthew Street. There's a picture going around. Marilyn, I have seen it. I saw it just about 20 minutes ago.
Now, is that because brass teeth don't look very good?
Someone's stuck these teeth on it. Oh. I'll show you it later. It does look funny.
Lovely Richard O'Cooley.
Richard O'Cooley.
O'Cooley or Cooley. Lovely nice name, isn't it? That sounds like a perfume. Are you wearing your Cooley tonight?
I'm wearing my O'Cooley.
A lovely Toshi Rushi from Hull.
Toshi Rushi turned 13 in 1987. It was his first year at Greatfield High.
I only had 1 year to go, doll, when I was in 97. I was out there by 88.
Talking of tall people, Alex Clark.
Oh,
is
that dashing busman.
Honestly, I thought Alex would have to wear, you know, like short round in Indiana Jones, then boxes on his feet to operate that bus. But no.
He don't need no boxes on his feet.
He'd be a little tight crushed inside his little bus cab.
You need it, you know. Leanne McGee said she was only 2 in 87. Little babies. You're little babies.
Oh, lovely Gabby Chassie from the States.
Hello, Gabby
here.
Chassie.
And Gabby Chessie says he misses Mr. and Mrs. Pie.
We've actually got some stuff on ice, haven't we?
I think we have. Top we might tips. Have.
Claire Prince. Ice with Quattro. I remember Quattro. It's quite nice. There was an advert last week. I don't know. We put an advert, didn't we?
What's Quattro? Was it like...
That
it was
full
like
drink thing.
Was it clear cola? Or was that tab?
No, it was lime. Was it lime mandarin? Something. Lucy Braithwaite.
From First Age Comics. Hello, my darling.
And we've got... Oh, it's a book.
Hang on. I think that's it.
Melanie says it's VK Black Cherry. We look lovely. Paul's popped in with
Paul's
no capitals. He's just saying hello to everybody in the Facebook.
And Andy Whittle is in. And Jason says he's a little bit like Rosemary, the telephone operator in Hong Kong Fooey.
All right, you can be here then.
So over in our room over here, Michael Darrington has joined us. Hello, Michael. And Dame Thora Heard has appeared as if by magic.
Also, no foul language tonight.
Heather Warren is in as well. Heather Warren's liking my blonde hair. So welcome, everyone. Good to see you all.
Now, we've got a few little shout-outs to do first before we get on with things. First of all, we'd send lots of love to our good friend Mark. He doesn't talk a lot on here, but he chats to us on Facebook Messenger sometimes. And he's had a bad week. His dog died. His dog Josh passed away this week. So we're sending you lots of love, Mark. And I'm sure all your fellow Wig and Slingback are sending love to you too. Isn't Josh a lovely name?
Oh, it is. Yeah.
So lots of love to you. And we've got some birthdays. To sort of celebrate that they've just gone past.
I get Wally Wallaby out.
Yeah.
Birthday.
So you might as well get, even though Cilla's not in, you might as well pop her on. So first of all, I'd say happy birthday to our wonderful Jason Darcy.
Happy birthday to you.
It's very quiet.
It might not be quiet for them. I think it's quiet because of our speaker.
And also, Philippe Jacques Fortinbras had a
happy birthday to you.
And our little lovebirds up in Scotland, Diangela and Paul, had a birthday this week.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday
to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Like, people don't let us down. Simon Jones says Quattro was pineapple, orange, and passion fruit and grapefruit. Awesome. It was the last word in exotique.
Oh, it sounds nice. Why did they stop that?
The receptionist has come through. She's handed me a card and saying, EastEnders, February 87, Wilmot Brown opened the Dagmar with Angie and Sharon. Sharon was away, probably in Panto. And Den's bit on the side, Jan, appeared and helped out in the Queen Vic.
Jan was, she was a lady, wasn't she?
Gary Donnelly's birthday is coming up soon. You don't get a happy birthday from anyone until your birthday's been Gary Donnelly.
Yeah, we'll do it next Gary Donnelly. Week. I'll hear you next week.
Pete Potowski says, can we all have a bit of a birthday boogie for Tracy's fella? So for Earl, who turns 40 very soon.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Will Venus says, we've missed her birthday the last two past years.
Oh, Will.
Will, when is your birthday? Let us know. Let us know.
Will.
Or, actually, Will Venus might be talking to Mr. Venus. I don't know. It gets confusing.
Well, Will, we will write it on the wall in lipstick to make sure we never forget. We can't forget Will's birthday.
Gary Donnelly says his mum's birthday was last year.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
And Sarah
says... What you don't see is Alan dances every time that goes on.
And Sarah Simms says she wasn't even born in 1987.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Oh, so that's birthdays done with for another week.
Oh.
I am here next week.
Oh, so.
I'm here next week. I'm not here the week after.
So we've had him 3 weeks in a row, folks.
Will's Venus is the 14th of October.
Eh?
We've not missed it. It's yet to come. Right, so I've been up in Liverpool. I've had a right nice time.
Oh, yeah, you said he's had a friend with time with your friends, haven't you?
I have.
Been friends with him for 30 years.
Yeah, it's about last year.
Or more.
Last week, just after the show, Peggy injured herself.
I don't know how she did it. I think she did it in the garden, in the dark.
So you can hear her whimpering, whinging.
That's because we're singing and dancing. She must be just says, shut up. Move the camera. Move. Where is she?
She's there. So yeah, she was limping. So she's been on rest.
Been on bed rest.
So Nurse Alan stayed with her and I hot-footed it across to Liverpool where I met with some of my friends from 32 years ago, a musical that I did. And then also spent time with Mum and Dad and Ewan and Marcia and my nieces. So it was really nice. I had a lovely time.
Yeah.
I like Liverpool. I'd forgotten how nice it is as a city. It is a good city.
You did quite a lot in those couple of days, didn't you?
Yes. Although, do you know what? I got a ticket from Liverpool to home and it was £6.95 on the train.
Is that a lot?
Yeah, it felt like a lot. And then when I come in the next day, a return ticket cost £5.95.
Oh, is it because of the day you're travelling?
No, a return ticket is just a pound cheaper than a single. Isn't that bonkers that they didn't tell me that and just say get a return?
Oh, they won't tell you that, darling. They want the money out of you.
News just in from reception.
Hmm.
Coronation Street. February 1987.
Yep.
Sarah Lou was born.
Oh, okay. Yep, yep.
And Bette and Alec teamed up to run the Rovers.
Really? Oh, I remember that.
Oh, I love reception, don't you? I don't have to do any homework.
Tushy Rushy says, February 87 was the month when Simon in Wixie, in EastEnders, found out that Pete Beale was his dad.
Do you think Tushy Rushworth would be like...
YTS.
YTS
reception.
No, someone who comes in with like press in a little trilby.
Yes.
I got something for you.
I got news for you. Straight from
it's me, Tushy.
Straight from the Humberside Press. and as he comes in, he sees Rigby on the reception. Hello, sweetheart.
Paul McFarlane actually says Cilla might not be here because she's not got over the shock of me returning to Liverpool. That's why she's not in Cilla. Someone come in late. SG Turner, hello. Don't be sorry you're late, you're here. And Gary Donnelly says...
It's so cute, isn't it? Because we wouldn't know whether they're late or not.
We wouldn't know.
They've just told us they're late. Yeah.
Gary Donnelly's just being a witty little chit-chatter. So we'll leave that. Do you like my top today, everyone?
Mm-hmm.
My little top.
Oh, yeah, do you want to stand
It's up? Quite camp, isn't it?
Yeah, not only has it got a wonderful front.
I don't know if I'd ever wear it out.
And it's actually a man's top, isn't it?
But it's got fringe. It's got fringed arms.
And a sequined...
And a sequined tiger.
Siberian tiger, is that?
I know, I feel a bit ABBA. I feel the sort of thing that Agnetta... If it was in a different colour, and, that Agnetta might wear.
And it's got a hood.
Little hood. Ah, oh, so
and he's got blonde
are.
Hair. Have you seen your blonde hair yet?
I've seen my blonde hair last week.
Oh, yeah. And I've got the same old rags on.
Ooh. Oh, no, you look nice, my lovely. Jay Shaw turned 14 in February 87. I was drinking Orangina, as I thought it was sophisticated because it was French. Oh, an Orangina bottle. Do you remember them? They were shaped like an orange.
And you could only drink it if it was shook.
Let's have a look, because I'm going to bring up some photos now of what you guys were doing in 1987. Well, not what you were doing, but what you looked like.
What you look like.
Hang on.
Have I got to guess who they are? Because I've not seen them.
Yeah. So I'm going to change it to that. I'm going to change that to that.
Well, that's you.
Put that there. They've not seen it yet.
Oh. Is that you in 87?
Me in 1987.
And who are you with?
Andy Wilde.
Ah. Are you in, what do they call it? The kid thing?
Yeah, Bugsy Malone.
That's the one. Oh, have you got one of your dad's ties on?
No, I most probably was costumed by... Oh, I can't remember. I think the costume house was called Masquerade.
Oh, really?
And I think Masquerade must have supplied my costumes.
And have you got a little, a proper suit on?
Oh, do you like my little moustache?
Yeah.
A little pencil moustache. The hat was way too big. But yeah, that was me in 1987. Yeah. And...
Oh, that was me.
That was you in 1987.
Roughly. Late 87.
Yeah. With your little tie clip. We've talked about that little tie clip.
Look at my real teeth.
Right, here we go. Let's have a look.
I'm Magelda.
We've got.
Oh my God. Let's see. That's somebody from America, isn't it?
I don't think we've met this person, so I wouldn't expect you to know who they are. But this is none other than Alex Johnston. So Alex is in, I think. I think Alex is over here.
Well, Alex, all I can say is love the shirt. Obviously, we share the same taste in shirts. And he's looking very, very...
Do you love the shades?
Yeah, he's looking very sure of himself,
shades.
Isn't he?
Shades.
And he's like, he's owning that zoo. It looks like he's in a zoo.
Now, is it... is Alex Alexander or Alexandra?
In this picture?
Yeah, I think this is Alexander, isn't it?
Yes.
This is a... Because this could very well be...
Is it the blouse?
Yeah, this well could very well be just a 30-year-old lesbian.
Well, I think it's a he, because he's tucked in.
I think it's a he. That's Alex. Alex Johnson. Let's have a look. I did say I'd be throwing shade at you all.
That is very shady. We know who that is.
We know who that is.
I don't even have to look at the person to know who that is. But that looks like it's a Robinson 3 tripod 48782.
I think Darren will let us know exactly what camera that is. But yeah, that is, of course, Darren Brambles, who was at college and was just learning all that that malarkey.
And it looks like he's sporting a very casual and comfortable batwing.
Maybe in a velour.
I
think it's a rugby top.
It's a collared jersey.
That was a TVS sweatshirt, says Darren, and he says he loved it.
And he's got a microphone, which means he must talk to the thing, the box upstairs.
I know, but he couldn't run around after Annika Rice with that, though, could he? It's
it could be on wheels. Oh, there he is again. Not only is he operating the camera...
He's also in the gallery.
He's in the gallery on the editing suite.
Same sweatshirt. The most recent same day.
He's not changed.
Same photo
he's
shoot.
He's not changed a bit, has he?
Yeah.
He's got a nice... I think he's got a little ring on. Can you see his little ring?
Yeah, it's a little signet.
Signet ring.
Darren Bramley. Steve 17... Stevie 17-ish is in. Hello, Stevie.
Oh, now I know who that is.
In the stripy dress.
Yes. Can tell. Because of her lovely curly hair.
That's our Shari.
Shari Gledhill.
So that's Bubbles.
What, is Nibbles with her there? With his long hair?
With his long blonde hair.
No, that, I think I've seen this photo before, I think, on one of our galleries. Because I just think that the girl's holding a Christmas pudding.
What's she holding?
It's one of them little balloons, isn't it?
I don't know.
Those little foil balloons on sticks.
Is it? In 1987?
Yeah.
Would they have been around?
At the seaside they were, because she's in Scarborough, isn't she?
Shari, what's your friend holding in her hand?
I've noticed something.
Peter Topsky said Darren Bramley's jumper was reminiscent of John Craven.
Yes. Now, if Shari took that coat off...
she would become...
She would be Ruth Ballinger.
Ruth Ballinger.
In,
terrorist from Cell Block H.
Yeah, and I can imagine her slinging a lipstick to a friend there.
So Shari said her and her mate came to Scarborough, I guess maybe to look at the college, because Shari was only 17 here and said she felt ever so grown up being away from home on her own. And there she is again.
And it looks like a very windy day. Oh,
different frock.
Different frock there.
In fact, I think different handbag.
Now that is proper.
Handbag?
Yeah, proper different.
Just a brown strappy handbag.
I don't think the handbag matches the shoes though, does it?
Here.
I don't think it matches the shoes.
White strappy handbag.
There she looks like a sort of like roving reporter, doesn't she?
She does.
Live from something Abbey.
Scarborough Castle.
Is it Scarborough Castle? Is it the same day?
Shari says it was a Thomas the Tank Engine balloon. Mm. So you're right.
So Shari, what is it? Scarborough Castle or some abbey?
It's that Scarborough Castle.
Oh, it's the same week.
Yeah,
is
yeah,
it?
That's Scarborough Castle. That's the keep. That's the prison. The jail.
But same weekend. Same.
Same weekend.
Same week.
Just different ensemble.
Yeah.
Different. Shari says she made the stripy dress herself.
Ooh.
Peter Tosky says, watch out for that well. Goodness me.
I think it's safe. Look, it's all barricaded in.
Do you remember when Beryl from Sons and Daughters falls down a well?
There's a funny funny video that somebody's like messed with and she sort of rings and it rings like a bell.
When she's swinging, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, dear me. Right, here we go. Another photo. Hang on.
Oh, now then.
I don't know you know this person. That is Mr. Colin Rhodes James.
Oh, hello, Mr. Colin Rhodes James. You look very handsome.
Doesn't he?
Those hairs. I remember those. I remember a lot of boys having hair like that.
Oh, like, he's older than me, though.
You either had the gelled hair, spiky hair, or you had it on a sort of a nice little fluffy short back and side.
Do you think Colin Rhodes James was at Sixth Form College?
Yeah, look at the hoodie.
Yeah.
That's confidence, isn't it? Wearing a... stripey hoodie like the hat.
Let's have a look.
It looks like he's somewhere pretty. Very handsome. Very handsome young man.
Let's have a look. Next one.
Oh, she looks like Kate Bush, doesn't she?
Kate Bush or Wanna Bananarama?
I think I've realised it's Jamshed Coral Daff.
It's Coral Daff.
And she, oh, doesn't she look lovely?
Doesn't she?
Look at her little face and a big hair.
Doesn't she look like one of Bananarama? Before, you know when they were funky? Before they got Stock Aitken Waterman.
She's very ruler, then. And they're a bit,
no, she is very ruler.
Coral, you got wonderful hair, love. Bloody hell. And she? You've got hair. You'd be proud of that hair, wouldn't you? Do you know, I'd love a wig like that. Wouldn't you?
Very thick. It feels very thick, that hair.
Oh, but look, it's got a lot of body to it, hasn't it?
Do you think there's a cheeky shoulder pad within that?
Well, she's got something off the shoulder, hasn't she? One jacket.
But in that white, do you think there's a little cheeky shoulder pad going on here?
Oh, yeah, there would have been shoulder pads in that. It's very similar to the handsome man's jersey before, isn't it?
Right, Alex Johnson has come back to say, I am very much a bloke. I was 8 in that pic. I loved that shirt. It was jungle and had elephants on it. I wouldn't be seen dead in a Hawaiian shirt now. We are. My brother said you used to be quite trendy. What happened? Alex, do you know what? I think you look a little bit like Corey Feldman from The Goonies in that. Do you remember Ralph Mouth? Not Ralph Mouth. Mouth from The Goonies. Corey Feldman, when he sort of was a bit of a Hollywood star, a part of the Brat Pack. That's what
it's the, what vibe, you know, it's the glasses, there. Isn't it? Because they're really big shades, aren't they? Like proper Hollywood shades.
All right, next person. We know who that is, surely.
Oh, it's Mr. Ibbotson, isn't it?
Yeah, isn't he a dish?
Isn't he gorgeous there, look?
Oh, isn't he a dish? Oh. Isn't it shiny straight, isn't it?
Oh.
Give me the lovely Pringle.
He's still handsome, though, isn't he?
He's proper moody teenage there, isn't he?
He is, yeah.
Leaning on the banister.
You can see the actor in him, yeah. Can't you?
Do you reckon he was going out for drinks by then? Yeah. Going out to the pub?
Yeah, that laughs. He's not a drinker, but I can see him having a laugh there.
Right, let's have a look who else. We're looking at the person laying on the floor, head in hands.
I think it's one of the Bobbins.
Yeah, it's Filippo Giacomo Brachiaforte.
Yeah, it's him.
Looks the same, doesn't he? Really,
it does. Because I was staring at that little face a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, I bet his mum was angry about them socks.
Is that not his trainers?
I think he's just in his socks.
Oh, I bet she had to get the personal out for them.
And I think that's his little brother and sister next to him there.
I think they're all in denim, aren't they?
I don't think sister's in denim. Not she might be.
Denim bottoms? Oh, now then. Oh, I recognise the face.
She was rebelling. She was uniform my arse from school. She was rebelling with a bit of hair dye, a bit of lippy, a bit of earring going on.
Is it your cousin?
No.
Do we know them?
It's our Helen from Hull.
No.
It's our very own dinner lady.
Know, Helen can go in so many disguises and I never recognise her. Do you remember she was dressed as that little boy from the tragedy?
From the frisbee advert.
I didn't know it was Helen. And then I said to you, who's that woman in the corner in the blue, in the orange cardigan? It was Helen again.
Didn't she look ace?
Yeah.
Next one.
It's because I'm used to seeing her in with Blondeur. Well, it's Formby something, so is it you?
Yeah, can you see me?
Oh, there you are. I can see your ears.
Ding. No. That was 1987.
Who's second in?
Next to me.
No, the one after that.
Rachel Ramsey. I won't say anything. She could be watching.
I know, but I'm saying, was she a girlfriend?
No. I didn't have a girlfriend.
I love
this
photos.
One in the middle. So here, this was her in the middle with the longish red hair was kind of my best friend, Fiona, at that age.
Yeah.
And we volunteered to do, like I've told you this, Parents' Evening, to do like the teas and coffees at Parents' Evening.
Mm.
And we used to dress up as Lizzie Birdsworth and Mrs. O'Regan because we had the run of like the kitchens, the school kitchens.
It started all those years ago.
And there's one more of me. There we go. That's the same. That's me. There we go.
Oh, you got some teeth missing.
Yeah, that was when I started having all that dental work.
And is that Ross scratching his hair?
No, that'll be Ross there, just behind here, and that's Ewan there.
With his hand on his hip.
Ross and Ewan, both in little Pringle sweatshirts.
How many years difference is between you and Ewan?
Ewan's same age. Ewan's four a year years. Older than you. So not much, 3.5.
Look, he's made a mountain, isn't he? He looks lovely in lemon.
Oh, you keep an eye on your comments. Mark Hall's complaining.
He says, well, he says it's sticking.
Maybe no one's commenting. There we go. We won't know. You won't know who that is, but that is Ian Sanderson.
Oh, lovely pussy.
Ian Sanderson looks a little bit like he works on local news, doesn't he?
Yeah, or is a vet, TV vet.
Yeah.
Here I am with Misty. Who...
Oh, he could be sat on Esther's little panel, couldn't he?
Yeah, very, very dashy man. He again looks like a roving reporter.
He does.
So look. That might pop in. Oh. Would I know this person?
You might do. You should do. But you won't recognise it because he's got a big beard now.
The BG Bear?
No.
They're loving Christmas.
It's Jason Brett.
Are we?
Married to James Brett.
No.
Married to James Brett, brother, one of my Eurovision twins.
Oh, wow. I've seen pictures of them, yeah.
Jason looks like he's in a leather tie.
Yeah, he does, doesn't he? And he's like loosened it for the Christmas party. Well, I hope it's
or just Christmas. For fashion. Next one. I don't think it's changed at all.
It's our receptionist.
It is. It's Jason from reception. And that's his mad auntie, he says.
He looks a little bit like Sandy Toksvig.
He does. Jason could also join that group of maybe kind of like could pass for a lesbian. You know what I mean by like a 1980s les. So like Greenham Common, Sandy Toksvig. Most like our friend's mam, who you always was wondering about.
Oh, he's lovely. Oh, I don't even know. I don't even need to say. It's Mr. Sandwell, isn't it?
It is Mr. Sandwell. And look at that tan.
Do you think it's from a buckle?
I think so. Mr. Sandwell. Should I zoom in on the face?
Do you know, I'm gonna say Nibbles.
It is Nibbles.
Yes, yeah. Because he was cheeky back then. I remember him saying it was all over the place, jumping about.
And he's blonde. Look at that.
Yeah.
A couple left. We've got.
Oh, that's Mr. Ribbons.
Mr. Ribbons, Bobbin Stoffer. Yeah. Looking a bit like a holiday rep.
Yeah, it looks like a sort of like, yeah, Spanish or Italian rep, doesn't he?
Yeah. We'd all have a crush on him.
Yeah, they're like, oh, he's coming down to the, he's in the taverna.
I got fingered by Carlos last night.
Yeah. Do you want a drink? Do you want me to buy a cocktail?
And the final one. Talking of local news.
It's Lady V.
Lady Vanessa.
Lady V.
Lady V. Sandwell.
Lovely her.
That's your lot of our 1987s. Common theme is that all of us, like all of you, well, grown-uppy ones, all looked like they were on local TV news. Yeah?
All lesbians.
And all of us young ones looked lesbians. Do you think I looked a bit les?
You do when you were sat on the stairs with a moustache on.
that one.
No, the one by the wall, no.
Shall I be like Victoria Wood now? No, we love you really.
No, really.
We love the guys.
Yep, yep.
We are going to have an advert break. 1987 adverts. We'll be back in about 4 minutes.
Wow. Talk about sheer terror. Well, what did you think so far? Listen, this side is about to come to an end, but I want you to be sure and flip over to the other side, where the best of Hollywood beckons. I'm going to freshen up a little bit, so I'll see you on the other side. Honey, why don't we get some more wine, more hors d'oeuvres, more everything?
Okay.
If you're thinking of selling your house, ask Whitegates for a valuation, completely free of charge. Whitegates, tomorrow's kind of estate agent.
Happy kids make a happy holiday at
Contents.
See your travel agent.
Welcome aboard, everybody. And
while you're on this foreign trip, stay fit and well. And don't forget to care for your gums, brushed with Mentadent gel for healthy teeth. You need healthy gums. For healthy gums, you better start young. Brushing helps to fight the plaque, for gum health it does excel. Take good care of your gums, brush with Mentadent gel.
Be chums with your gums with new Mentadent gel. Thank you.
Colwyn Bay is the heart of the North Wales coast. For your free full-colour Colwyn Bay brochure, ring 061 228 1166 now.
You want your savings in a hurry? You gotta wait in line. And just when you're getting there, it's a waste of time. There's a new idea from NatWest Bank. You can get a service card with an online account. If you're over 14, try this new transaction. Just scroll on up and press for action. Your money in your hand around the clock. So you can do what you're doing with no need to stop. So if you find you're losing out, cause to get your own cash you have to hang about, make sure you don't get left behind. You better get wise and get online. NatWest Online. Press for action. Action.
always pass on your postcode so you're properly addressed when people reply. Because postcoded letters whiz through our machines far faster than sorting by hand. So pass on your postcode. Write it, quote it, use it. It means mail gets sorted faster, helping us to help you.
Pass on your postcode, you're not properly addressed without it.
Where'd you keep the Nescafe jar?
Car's in the garage.
Nescafe!
Yes, please. Top right-hand cupboard.
Large or small?
Yes. Best taste of all.
He's got the message. Only Nescafe has that special blend and roast for that richer, smoother taste.
How's the coffee coming?
It's here! And there's no need to shout.
Oh, I don't know. Why keep quiet about Nescafe?
Nescafe. Coffee at its best.
Speak to us, Sydney. Are you there, Sydney? Are you there, Sydney? Sydney?
Somebody somewhere is having a toffee crisp.
Cola water. Cola water. Cola water. Cola water.
Body active.
Cola water.
Body passive.
Cola water.
Body slim and body massive.
The way we're living today. Still gonna want bottle.
Whole milk.
Bottle.
Skimmed milk.
Semi-skimmed.
Yeah. What?
The new Strongbow.
No way.
It's quite a bit drier, fuller flavoured.
All right, then.
Who's that, darling?
Nothing, love. Just a new Strongbow.
Strong, straight, true,
Hi, I'm back. And so are you. You know, I feel as though I know you. Well, at least we share some of the same tastes. Oh, I'm sorry about the cheese puffs. I ran out. But I still have quiche.
Pass on your postcode. You're not properly addressed without it.
I hope Jason Rigby, our receptionist, is on hand, because I'd like to know the name of the man in the coffee commercial that was from That's My Boy.
The one who was in, like, a throuple with Gareth Hunt and Diane Keane.
And Melanie Fairley just said, oh, it's what's it from That's My Boy. So we'd like to know.
It was quite sexy, wasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. That's My Boy.
Jason won't even need to get his Rolodex out for that, I don't think. I think he'll be straight on it. Yeah, 1987, the year when banks started having bank machines, I guess.
And Tushy Rushy's just said it's the final episode of Victoria Wood's seen on TV, 1987.
Oh, wow. Was that? I wonder when the Christmas special was where I got into Victoria Wood. Oh, that would have been 1987 Christmas, I think, because I've been third year.
Jay Shaw's come up with a name before...
before our receptionist is in. Simon Jones says Molly Sugden was in it. Lily Laura over here says Christopher Blake.
Christopher Blake. Oh, here she is. Chris Blake. Not here she is, but...
And did you spot Nana Royal?
Oh, in the Tolly Toffee Crisp advert, yeah.
It's a great advert, isn't it?
You can
Toffee
see why
Crisp.
She got that part, can't you? That advert.
Well,
and Mr. Ray Winston.
Ray Winston,
in the cider advert.
Let's have a look at what we were up to, what we'd have been watching. So,
we've not even done that bit
We've
yet,
not done we? That. So it's our telly from 1987, what me and Alan was going to be watching. So
it's a Sunday night, isn't it?
It's a Sunday night.
So it's... day before school or college.
So we got the...
Unless it was half term.
We got our radio times out and our TV times. And we had a little look through to see what was on.
Yeah, Sunday morning. Not all that gripping, was it?
Well, I'm starting Sunday morning. So I am going to watch some Sunday morning. I would most probably have watched Whackaday in the morning.
Was that on a Sunday?
The Wide Awake Club. Yeah, Tommy Boyd, a bit of Timmy Mallett. But I would have definitely watched this cartoon... which I bet you can't even remember.
Did they have American accents?
Yeah. And I bet some of you out there are already singing the theme tune to this.
Well, it's not Robin Hood, is it? It's not like it's not.
Someone type in the first line of the theme song to this cartoon. I'm not going to say what it is. I'm not going to say who it is. They're a bit like Robin Hood, though. Look at them.
Yeah.
It's not the biscuits. Jay Shaw has said what it is, but I want the first line of the theme tune. Do 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 do. Philip Jackson's got it. Gummy bears bouncing here and there and everywhere.
What? Gummy bears is in the sweets.
The gummy bears. So I would have watched the gummy bears. Which do you think is my favourite gummy bear?
I'm going to say the one with the little feather in its hat. Pink one.
The little pink one. But which one do you think reminds me of you?
Oh, she's there with no... She's got no shoes on. There she is. She like a kook or something.
None of the gummy bears wear shoes. Oh, hang on.
Excuse me. I see a pair of green booties and some sandals.
Anyway, so I had to watch the gummy bears.
Well, we are daft, aren't we?
Alan's TV doesn't start until the evening. So would you have been busy during the day on a Sunday?
Sunday dinner, washing up, see nanas.
Both nanas?
Yeah, March must probably meant perhaps gardening, starting the gardening.
What, at your house or at Nana's house?
No, at our house.
But then you'd get home and your first telly...
Oh. Yeah, and this is, like 4:45, isn't it?
This around so you can get that picture in.
This is like 4 o'clock in the afternoon. 50 minutes for Tom and Jerry. My life used to stop whenever Tom and Jerry was on. I loved them.
Do you, did you feel sorry for Tom?
The cat?
Yeah.
Well, he was a little bit daft, wasn't he?
So I always thought Jerry was a bit smug.
Well, Jerry was smug because he kept escaping him. And, he used to chase him around the house, but there was a lot of love there.
Why do you think they've got their whiskers like that in this picture?
It might be because they're reading and being intellectual, perhaps.
Oh, yeah, so they've done little intellectual moustaches.
Yeah, also, I'm not keen on this new revamped Tom and Jerry thing.
Both Jason Darcy and Melanie Fairley have both said, Thomas!
Oh, it's like when Mama was in it.
Mammy Two Shoes, she's called.
With a sort of, like, saggy tights.
Yeah, I think she's a bit light.
I said tights. Saggy tights and slippers.
Who was their like mate that was a dog?
Oh, was he called Rufus?
No. Spike. And he was like a big sort of a dog. And Jerry had like family, didn't he?
Sorry?
Did Jerry have family?
Yeah,
he would come in it. Little like
a little grey mouse that he fell in love with.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, there's a little grey mouse that was a female.
I used to think that Morph and Chaz fell in love.
Who's Morph and Chaz?
Morph is Tony Hart's little red claymation person. And Chaz was like a little grey clay one. Nice thing. Oh, they love us.
Chaz. But yeah, I used to love Tom and Jerry.
Here we go. Joel William Hazeldine has said it's Spike the grey dog.
Yeah.
Stephen Butler, who is in and has just let himself be known right now. Stephen Butler has said, now, I've heard that the singer of the Gummy Bear theme tune is the lead singing voice of adult Simba, the Lion King, and the lead singer of Toto and the son of John Williams, but he's only heard that from an internet video, so it's likely to be untrue.
Looks like Stephen's after Jason's job.
A receptionist job, yeah. So Alan's going to be watching Tom and Jerry.
Only for 15 minutes.
Meanwhile, same kind of time, I'm going to be watching... It's the Muppet Show!
Oh, yeah, that was great. That was fab.
You must have loved the Muppet Show as well.
Yeah, we watched it as a family.
I loved it. I love the Muppet Show.
Do you know what I liked about it? It was a long show.
Was it? It was only about half an hour, wasn't it?
No, for a kid,
maybe it was a
family
bit longer.
Show. But for, you know, kids' shows were really short, weren't they? But Muppet Show was, and it was a lovely long show. It was nice.
Do you remember they had like really funny special guests that you'd never heard of?
Oh, yeah.
Like Ethel Merman would be on it, or Liza. Yeah. You'd be like, Mum, who's that?
I remember the Raquel Welch thing when Animal bit her or something.
Oh, yeah, you're scared of Animal because of that, weren't you?
And I was scared of them big things because I once saw them swallow something.
Swallow a Muppet?
Yeah. A little, oh, not really.
Can you see my favourite Muppet? There she is in the middle.
In the band?
Janice. Look at her. Hey, man. She's looking in the canon. No, she's just like hippied out. Look how weird Miss Piggy looks in the early days.
Oh, yeah.
She's not glamorous. The little orchestra. Oh,
I used to love the dog on the piano.
Rolf. Do you remember the little stage manager, Skeeter?
Yeah, he's got a clipboard.
There he is. Or he might be called Scooter. Or might be... There he is.
Yeah.
With the little glasses on.
But I used to love all the ones that didn't talk.
Do I remember saying...
The little extras, or the little worm or something, or the little...
Ethel Merman gets someone over. It might be Scooter. She goes, I need to change dressing room. There's a mouse in my dressing room. And they go, don't worry. She'll be out of there soon. She's on first.
But things like, you know, the little flying thing in the air.
Yeah.
And there's somebody actually coming down. There's somebody upside down with tights on. Who's
that's a pig in roller skate. Oh, no, that's a pig doing
it. But it was those characters that I loved, the ones that, that weren't the star of it.
Can you see Statler and Waldorf?
Yeah,
there
but the effort they made down. Into... Oh, and the newsreader.
Oh, wonderful. Muppet Show.
What was the guy called?
He is called Scooter. In the Muppet Babies, he has a sister called Skeeter, I think, which is what I got confused.
The band was almost electric,
Dr. Teeth.
Dr. Teeth. And the band was called Electric
Dreams. Electric Mayhem.
Electric Mayhem.
I love Electric Mayhem. I listen to their songs.
There's a little baby frog.
That's Robin. That's Robin. Kermit's little nephew. Jerry's mouse cousin was called Nibbles Toffee Mouse. Says Paul McFarlane, and he whispers it. No capitals. Paul and Jason Darcy's shouting pigs in space.
Should we call Nibbles? Nibbles Toffee Mouse from now on.
Stefan's had to apologise to Jason Rigby.
She said, but Rob, that's my job.
Oh, I love the lot of you. Right, let's have a look. So, I'm watching Muppets. Alan is watching. Alan's turning over at 6 o'clock.
Oh, every so well, it was because of me dad. It was his program on a Sunday. I loved it
because I used to answer
all the questions correctly.
Or did you get told off for being clever?
Yeah, smart. But yeah, but like I was always good at faces. That's Jill Gascoigne, Dad.
It's faces for 20.
Yeah. Oh, it was a great. They fit so much into this half an hour show.
We should do another episode of Bullseye, shouldn't we?
We split should ourselves we? Into. You were a bit with the editing. You were a bit freaked out by the editing.
Oh, it was the editing was hard work.
We'd have to borrow Martin's bully again.
Oh yeah, we've given it back to Martin, the bendy bully.
And I'm not into all the remakes of this. No,
it's coming back. I think with Paddy McGuinness.
No, just Jim.
It's coming back because of that 17-year-old that everyone was crazy about at Christmas.
I just love the Jim one.
We can't remember who he is now, can we? But yeah, I think that's why it's coming back.
I didn't like it when Thingy brought it back. Was it the squeaky? What's the squeaky one called? Was it Alan Carr did it or somebody brought it? Oh, that guy from the one goes.
Here we go.
Come get your back, being bad.
Dave Spikey.
Dave Spikey did it, didn't he?
Never failing to make me chuckle or come in with a comment. Helen from Hull has just come in with the classic comment, I've had dinner with Tony Green. It doesn't surprise Helen. You, does it?
Helen, I would love to be a member of that table.
Oh, Jason says there's loads of people in the West Midlands still have a speedboat parked on their hard standing.
Your heart dropped when that was your prize. And I saw one, it was in the early days, that these two blokes were, you know, they were like workmates, and they won a fitted kitchen. I mean, how would you share that?
Monsieur Brambles has just chipped in with...
Did he film it?
They had several top prizes at the back of the set, and they just decided what would get wheeled out at the last minute.
Oh, really? What they wanted rid of?
Yeah.
Do they live near the coast? Quick, get them a speedboat!
Right, so Alan's watching Bullseye, and meanwhile, I, being the good Christian boy that went to a Christian primary school, I'm going to be watching Highway.
Welcome to Highway!
Now, why I'm watching Highway is not necessarily because of Jesus. It's not because of God made this lovely anorak,
especially for me.
It's because the theme tune is wicked, man.
Oh, I can't remember it.
Listen to the theme tune and just, I'm going to like move and dance to the
theme
tune.
Are you going to play it? Will we not get into trouble?
I hope not. I'm going to keep my eyes on Cilla's police. The theme tune is genuinely a funktastic tune. Right, here goes. Theme's coming up. Hopefully you'll be able to hear it.
Jesus. Hello, I will this week come from Ipswich, the county town of...
I remember the hello bit.
Isn't it amazing?
There was always like a long pause. Hello!
Bow, bow. But can you imagine me
What lifting is that?
Can you imagine me in a little unitard dancing to it?
Yeah, with one of those, like, you know, the ribbons on a stick.
Right.
Wow.
Turn that down.
I've just missed something, a little comment on this. Rushy Tushy about... Tushy Rush said, he said it before, but Tony Green was his mother's ex when they were young.
Naughty, it's a joke.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, keep going.
So every time he bellows, in two, I shove... Oh, you pull him a leg. I thought he was Trone.
Highways got a fab theme tune, says Alex Clark. Jason Rigby on reception has also pointed out that there was an upbeat theme tune at the end of Blockbusters if they won, but a downbeat theme tune if they lost.
On Bullseye or
Blockbusters? On Bullseye.
You said Blockbusters.
Bullseye, God, forgive me.
I thought he was going to say Highway then. Can you imagine?
So yeah, Highway. Highway for me, mainly for that cheesy theme tune.
And it wasn't all that religious, was it?
There was an undercurrent of Jesus running through it all.
I mean, you could sort of see Thora on that, couldn't you, as well?
Wasn't Thora on it?
She was on Praise Be.
Songs O' Praise.
Praise Be, wasn't it?
Praise Be, she was.
She was on BBC One. This was ITV, wasn't it?
Do you reckon they were mates or rivals?
Oh, they were mates.
You don't think they, like, gave each other side eye? They must have done the Groucho.
They must have done a movie together.
Alan is tuning in to...
That's probably about 7.15.
About 7.15, BBC One.
Last of Summer Wine. Oh, it went on for years, didn't it? And I think round about 86, 87 is the first sighting of... Because she was in it a lot earlier.
Is she not in the first series, though? First couple of series?
No. She was in it for years, but round about the late 80s she was in it.
It's a little bit like the Sugar Babes. What's your favourite incarnation of Last of the Summer Wine? Now, the Sugar Babes are always, like, changing. Members leave, members come.
It's these three... The guy from Porridge.
Yeah.
Some of the ones that replace him.
Compo and Clegg and...
Weren't all that
Lofty,
great.
Is he called now? I can't remember.
And then obviously when Compo died and then the other two got too old, it was like Russ Abbott and...
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's like Sugar Babes.
Not Gokwan. What's the other one called? Burkwok.
Burkwok.
Can you imagine Gokwan in that? Oh, come on. Nora, let's get you looking pretty.
Getting Nora in a waspy belt and a wide 50s skirt.
And all the, when Thora heard again, she was in that, wasn't she? I was watching them all on UK Play recently, past couple of years. They rerun them.
Mark Hall would like to know, do they ride a bathtub down a hill in every episode?
No, not every episode, but there is some kind of calamity, an old ice cream van, or obviously Nora's in an old pram. And where it's filmed is very hilly, so you're bound to put those kind of storylines in, aren't you, really?
Ladies and gentlemen, Ribbons Bobbin Stuffer has officially changed his name to Carlos Bobbin Stuffer now, after our comments earlier. Carlos would like us to know that he was in the Sugar Babes in the briefly in the 80s.
We're fingering people.
Right, shall I go on to my next one?
Yeah.
My next one's a random one, but at 7.15, I'm turning on to BBC Two, and I'm going to watch On the House with Patty Colwell.
What the hell is this? Oh my, is it Ursula Summer? Oh my.
Look at Patty Colwell with her.
Is that fabric or wallpaper?
Wallpaper. It's a DIY show.
Who's that with a drill?
I'm not sure. Rick, I think one of them's called Rick Hall. The drill's a woman, isn't she? Anyway.
So how would you get bubbles out of wallpaper on your wall?
Basically, what it was that the Pebble Mill gang decided they'd like to, like, try and do something at the weekend. Mm. So they created a little DIY show. And on the episode, the Radio Times I was looking at, all it says about this episode is Patty Caldwell tries to install a phone extension into the Pebble Mill house.
And the perfect choice. Ian Tushy Rushy said it's a true story about
Tony Green dating his mum. Dame Thora Heard has officially said in the chat there, "I'm going, we were rivals, we don't speak."
Mark Monday and Pearson just said he went home first last week. And he popped to see Compo and Clegg's graves because they're buried together.
Oh, really? Is Clegg Wallace and Gromit?
Yeah, they're buried next to each other.
Peter Salis.
They're really good friends, those two, in real life. Oh, that must have been lovely to see.
Oh,
lovely. So, yeah, I can see her, like, with a hammerhead drill.
She'd have a she'd need a ratchet. She wouldn't use a ratchet screwdriver, would she? It don't get purchased.
It don't get bloody purchased. I'm in that plane for cutting door.
Okay, so Alan's Sunday night evening continues with.
And she's not even bloody here to enjoy it.
She's not here.
She's not here to enjoy her praise.
Life is full.
Now this I loved because it was an hour of. It was like a box of dolly mixtures. 1 minute somebody's pretending to be a hair hostess, and next minute she's reuniting people from Canada. And the thing is, my dad used to sort of sit right near the TV and watch them cry at the end.
What do you mean, sit by the TV?
He was always like sat near it. And he'd cry, but we couldn't see him cry. He'd snivel at the sad bit. We'd go, you're crying, are you, Dad?
What, like when some old twins are reunited?
Yeah.
Do you remember Pat and Margaret is kind of based on Surprise, Surprise, isn't it?
Mm.
Cilla's outfit there.
I know, it's lovely, isn't it? I think it's a trouser suit.
I don't remember her wearing that sort of thing in Surprise,
Actually,
Surprise.
Actually, I think it's a jumpsuit, isn't it?
Yeah, it must be an early Surprise, Surprise.
It's 1980s. I do when I pick my photos, I try and keep them to date. Yeah, it was. I loved Surprise, Surprise.
Do you know what? I bet Cilla like was forever beggaring about with those cushions to the crew. Do you reckon she got annoyed with the crew and said like, "Oh, them cushions.
Yeah,
you're gonna have to do something about those cushions.
They're very slippery.
I'm slipping off." Carlos Bob and stuff has said I used to play the phone game with my nan on Surprise, Surprise. I don't remember what the phone game was.
Could you phone in or something?
Cilla's off rigging, says Jason Darcy. That's why she's in that outfit. She's off rigging later.
Somebody's popped in called Feed Me Seymour.
And she says, I've seen your Keeping Up Appearance intro. One of the funniest things I've seen. You've portrayed all the characters really well.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Cilla from Studio One LWT, says Darren Bramley there. And our receptionist has popped in with news that the highway composer was called Ronald Cass, who was involved in some of the music from the Cliff film Summer Holiday.
It's on my mind now. It's in my memory. It might go on my iPod.
Hang about. People are going. I can see some of you are leaving, but we have a classic Sunday night finale for you. So if you can hang out for the finale, do, because honestly, you won't want to miss it. Right, my number four in my five programmes is... Oh, no, I'm at my last programme.
Already?
My last programme is 8:35, BBC One, Mastermind. It would be on. Mum and Dad most probably watched it and answered questions. I would never get a question right. Would you? You were,
no. Unless it was chips or... Not the potato, but the program or...
the California Highway Patrol.
Yeah, or something.
But all their specialist subjects were just mad, weren't they?
What it was like the black hole.
What would be your specialist subject?
I don't know, really.
Cell Block H? You know a lot about Cell Block H.
Must be Fanny Craddock, Cooks for Christmas.
Just those five episodes.
Yeah.
You do know everything about
that,
don't you?
Yeah, Mincemeat Crepe. Because they try and catch you out, don't they? Like, who was the sound recorder?
Yeah. That's my last programme.
Very intellectual day for you, isn't it?
It is a very... Well, it's Sunday.
Bit of Highway, bit of Mastermind, bit of Patty Bloody Blabel. What's her name? Patty... Coopland.
Patty Colwell.
Colwell drilling through a bloody wall.
To be honest, I would have watched Surprise, Surprise, but you'd already picked it. And I would have watched Bullseye, but you'd pick that.
And he also picked this last one, which I picked.
And we would have.
This was an amazing programme. Look at them gnashers.
Not only the gnashers, but look at them gums.
Oh, I know. Oh, she's strong. She's got strong teeth there, hasn't she?
Do you reckon she smiled for so long that that bit of gum went dry?
Yeah, and then the lips got stuck a bit. Like an old cart horse.
So when they finished, did she have to do that and like pop it across?
Maybe
Richard Stillborn would have done that.
Bloody love Esther Ranson.
Oh, I love Esther. I think she's classic, going through, great in it.
Isn't she going through loads of grief at the moment?
Yeah, but she's living her life and her disease with dignity, and I love her.
I love that woman. But I used to love That's Life. Oh, even the bit when they used to go on the street and go, have you tried this crisp flavour? Or, you know, it was ever a while. Do you know about edible knickers?
Melanie Fairley says, and this is true for me as well, the theme tune always meant it was bed and school in the morning.
And I must probably smell a bit of carbolic soap or coal tar soap.
Because you'd had a bath.
Yeah.
Do you remember the end credits was like a cartoon of what you'd just watched?
Oh, yeah.
Feed Me Seymour, who doesn't know, most of you doesn't know what this programme is, says they look like false teeth in that photo.
And you love the bit where she, there was a serious thing about somebody who said, all my windows fell out of my house. Unfortunately, they couldn't replace the windows in the house, and the family froze to death. Doc. And then Doc would sort of
read a funny poem. Pete Petrovsky's also said, I love the cartoon credits, that cued bedtime. MP says, what about Howard's Way? It wasn't in that Radio Times that week. We're picking specifically from a day in history. So this Sunday in 1987, we were picking from.
And also, That's Life had, you know, Doc would have his little bit. But Molly Sutton did it for about a year and a half. Victoria Wood did it. Sing some of her songs on it. I'm not sure about Thor. June Whitfield, I think, did some.
Dazza Brambles says, That's Life, I used to sit in the back of the BBC TV theatre with my dad next to Esther's husband, Desmond Wilcox.
Oh, did you? And it went on to the mid-90s, didn't it, That's Life?
Yeah, do you remember? And Esther had them, like, three sort of men with her. And they'd read things out in a serious voice.
So what happened to the slag heap? Well, we spoke to Mr. Slagheap himself, and he said,
hello, I'd like to... Tushy Rushworth says, here we go, news clippings, rude-shaped vegetables, a sad story, a Jobsworth award, Doc Cox, a terrible song, end puns, that's every episode done.
Amazing. And who can forget...
Oh, I love a talking dog. If you showed me a video of a talking dog from the 80s, I'll be crying.
Did the blazer pull on his little mouth?
Jason Darcy says he's got Bill Buckley as a friend on Facebook. Lovely guy.
Oh, I think my friend Gareth has as well.
There was a guy called Adrian Mills from That's Life, and he went to my high school. The only famous person ever to go to my high school. So in our foyer there was a signed photo from him. Yes, folks, I did go to this school.
Adrian Mills. That guy with the curly hair, the bright eyes, wide eyes. And then there was one called
Gavin who had like hair like a bit like a Miller pad.
That's him. And then there used to be a guy with big massive like glasses.
Yeah. And a bit of a girly haircut.
Yeah.
A bit like Mr. Spooner.
Yeah. I don't remember what his name is.
Hi, my lovelies. Mika Magic has popped in. Hello, love. We'll see you on Friday night.
Yeah, Friday is our. I don't know how many we've done.
Friday night's our quiz.
Quiz night.
Friday night, we're going to try out our air hostesses for those of you that are there. So we're going to be taking to the skies.
We're flying the flag.
So I've been writing my quiz questions. I've not done my picture quiz yet. I've got to do that tomorrow. I meant to do it today.
It's okay.
So we're getting ready for the quiz. Quiz night on Friday night. We will take photos and share them here.
Oh, Philippe said his mother couldn't abide That's Life, so he never watched it.
Oh, what on earth would you watch instead? London's Burning. London's Burning was like a Sunday night, wasn't it?
Yeah, come on, Sick Note.
What was
they put a fire out, Sick Note.
What was the woman called? Something like...
The one used to cut the food?
No, there was a woman fireman.
Oh.
Did they give her a name? Like,
oh, she had really short hair.
Like Twinkle Tits.
Yeah, something like, put that fire out with Twinkle Tits. I remember Sick Note, and there's been old women used to cook their food.
Darren Bramley comes in with a little snippet before Jason Darcy. They're all vying for the receptionist job now. Darren says Gavin from That's Life was in the On the Buses film as a motorcycle policeman.
How was he? Oh, wow.
Archie Diggins says, oh, will we get a quiz here again? Yeah, we will. Well, definitely, we've got loads of quizzes we could do here.
It's just been times. For this one, when he's travelling a lot at the moment, aren't you?
We're travelling a lot, and we were so ill for two months.
2 months last year, it was awful. We had that awful thing that was going around. Well, I had it twice back to back.
Oh, Pete Potowski says there was also on a Sunday night Spitting Image on ITV. I think I'd have watched Spitting Image. No, I'd have watched Spitting Image in bed, and then I would have watched Bum Bum Bada 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 Bum Bum Ba Bum Bum Ba Bada Bada Bum Bum Ba.
South Bank Show.
Yeah.
Just only if it was something interesting.
I would have watched it anyway because I was like into theatre. And then I would have watched, and Mum and Dad mostly wouldn't have known this, but then I would have watched Cell Block H.
On a Sunday night?
Yep. Cell Block H, Granada, Sunday night.
Not a bloody Yorkshire. It was Monday
probably night. Till about half midnight.
I was just Monday nights, 11 till like 12.
I think it was Sunday night and Thursday night. And it went on past midnight.
And now ours did. Monday night.
Right, lovelies. It's 9:15, so we're going to end, but we're going to stay around for a drink afterwards with you all.
We'll have a little lock-in.
But we'll have a little finale, because I know you like them. And this pretty much sums up why I chose Highway as one of my hits.
Hello. Highway this week comes from Ipswich, the county town of Suffolk. We start the programme in this shopping centre, the town's newest acquisition. There's a very good reason for that, which I'll tell you about later. But first, watch this.
Get about 20 or 30 people in Brunswick Scarborough shopping mall dragged up to recreate that.
Would you all come and do it if we get all the wig and sling back together and we all bring a 1980s dress?
We've got plenty of wigs, so don't need to bring a wig. And we'll just.
Ooh, he'll buy.
Some of them are so loving it, aren't they?
They're loving it.
There's a lot of Highway fans in that, though. There's a lot of. Some of the old women love the Lord.
Love the Lord. Darren Bramley says all those twin sets. First Stage Comics says, oh, I want to be in this. Lily Law says it's a Women's Institute flash mob. Simon Jones says, did Bob Fosse direct this? Let's have a look. Feed Me Seymour says, imagine if you're walking down the street and suddenly the florist starts singing in this fashion and gathering as a crowd. I'd run away thinking it was a cult. Bibitovsky says the worm has turned. Martin Sullivan says they would have filmed that on a Sunday as the shops would have been closed in those days. And Neil Sandell says, oh my god, I've just seen a top Lady V had when we got married.
Can you have some comments on here? I think
here we go. Carlos says this is always happening in my local shopping centre. Mark Mundaman says, I had to look twice then. I thought one of the lady singers was Dermot Morgan in a frock.
And this is, Jay Shaw says, they're all rushing for the sale and Summers. Mark says, it's a beautiful shopping, 80s shopping centre.
It is, and they showed it off to all its glory, didn't they, by even using the telephones there at the end.
One thing you can most probably say with certainty is they all had their best dress on.
Do you think? Do you think they were dressed, or do you think there was a costume?
No, they brought their own. I think they said, you know, could we have an array of colours, perhaps?
Can you imagine like the rehearsals and stuff? Because it's quite choreographed.
Oh, I bet
there would have been like
there'd have been some kickoffs. You know, that wouldn't have gone smoothly. And I would imagine during their like when they're doing the lighting, they're in little cliques.
Now, Timmy Alexis Carrington Ward will take responsibility for that clip, but I'd found that clip years ago.
Harry Hill did one, didn't he? I think. Yeah.
But it is in one of Timmy's Here She Is episodes when Timmy watches a clip with a celebrity. He watches that and they talk about what's going on in people's heads, and it's very funny. I can't remember which Here She Is episode it is, but his director's commentary over that is really fun. Feed Me Seymour says, do people remember when shops closed half a day on Wednesday?
Yeah. I mean, it used to happen here.
I think it was different days.
When we first moved here, a lot of shops closed Mondays, aren't they? I think because they'd work the weekends because of tourism. But a lot of people now are 7 days a week.
Where I grew up in Formby, it was definitely Wednesdays was half day closing.
Yeah.
Henrietta Sausage says, it's the lady in the leopard print tripping over that makes me laugh.
Oh, well spotted. Yeah, we saw her.
Neil Sandwell says, it's mostly drip-dry fabrics.
And I don't think that leopard print was, I don't know, it didn't seem her, did it?
Darren Bramley's coming. He says he knows the director of that, of that actual piece, that footage. We'd love to interview him specifically about that.
We want to recreate it, tell him.
We want to find out exactly, like, yeah, Darren could come and help us with all the shots, couldn't he? Know exactly where to get them shots. How to get us coming down that escalator. Oh, do you reckon they had to do that a few times, the escalator bit? Because people weren't in shots and
they're
stuff.
They're in heels as well, aren't they?
Darren says he also used to do Get Fresh as well, that director. Pete Petrovsky says, Victoria Wood used to watch that Who Will Buy every Christmas in her last years. Philip Yakimo reminds us that pubs used to shut for a couple of hours in the mid-afternoon.
They did?
I used to work in
three till six, wasn't it?
But that'd be when I was, even when I was like, when I was working, because I was working in, I used to work in a restaurant and people would come to, it would get busy after the pubs had closed because people could come and drink in our restaurant because it was like a bar.
Well, I remember
as long
when,
as they got food.
I think I remember when it actually came out that they were going to be open all day. There was like, oh God, what's going to happen now? People be walking around drunk on the streets.
Hi, Thomas. Thomas Corrigan has just arrived.
Hi, Thomas. How are you?
Everyone say hello to Thomas.
And some of you, you could just bob your head down a bit. Some of you might notice there's something on the wall. Yep. There, look. Mrs. Mangle's made it up to the office.
Okay. Mrs. Mangle portrait.
Yep. That's because Jamie got me some lovely prints for Christmas. The artist.
Shall I run down and get one?
Yeah, yeah.
Which one should I get? I'll get the middle one, yeah?
Yeah. So you got these lovely two prints for Christmas. I can't remember what the name is called of the artist, but Jamie will know because he's been cahoots with him. So we've got these two lovely prints, and then the artist very kindly has given us a third print, which came through the post this week, which I think Jamie might try and pull up a picture of it. I think he's only going to bring one up. But they're lovely. They're lovely, lovely prints. They're very me. I don't know how he finds his wonderful presents, but he always does. Of course, he searches through Etsy and eBay and Vinted and what have you. And he always gets me a lovely present. And this, when I opened on Christmas Day, was just the bee's knees. I'm not sure we showed them this before. So there's this one, and the other one is Hetty from Dick Emery, and she's got a similar sort of hairdo, well, the hair, stuff in the hair. And then the third one this week, what we got, is Fanny Craddock. So we'll pop on pictures on Facebook, on social media, of the prints. What's the artist called?
Villain, Art by Villain. And the series is called Bonaria, which is Polari for nice hair.
And the lovely thing about the Mrs. Slocum prints and the...
Mrs. Slocum one goes...
got pussy in the hair.
Yeah, Pete, you're like that. The all the proceeds from this one, the sale of this one...
went to a cat charity.
Goes to a cat, yeah, to a cat home.
So every person who buys one, the money of that goes to a cat home.
And there's... I think this is... there's 100 of those. So they're limited editions. This is 100. And the other ones that we've got are 50. And he also does... in the Bonaria one, there is Alison Steadman as Beverly from Abigail's Party, and she's got cheesy pineapple things in her hair, and Demis Roussos.
And I saw this week, there's a Julie Walters one of her when she's in the shoe shop. So she's got this, like, liquid all sorts, hens, and a broken heel.
And there's also Margot from The Good Life. So, yeah.
They're great.
They're really nice, and they're, they're reasonable. So we'll put some photos on our social media.
So yeah, that's why Mrs. Mangle's come up here, because she was on our main wall. But Molly's taken that position now.
Mark Hall says, it's not often I say this, but I love her pussy.
I love her pussy. I love her little pussy.
Simon Jones says, Fanny Craddock always looked like a cross between Margaret Thatcher and Bette Davis in Whatever Happened to Baby Jane. Yeah, she did. Good. That's a good
fierce. She sort of looked fierce, didn't she? She was fierce.
Oh, I've still got loads to drink. I'm out of breath because I just ran down.
And there's a lot of stairs
all
in
those
our
flights
house.
Of stairs.
If I'd have gone for it, you'd still be waiting here.
We're up in attic.
We're up in attic. So, yeah, this Friday we've got our next quiz. We're looking forward to it, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, a few people had to cancel, which is... We're sad about that because they come every... to everyone,
but the tickets then got snapped up straight away,
and
so we're sell out.
It's a sort of little pilot. No, is that the right word?
Yeah, we're trying out the air hostesses to see how they go down, how we can do it. I had right to do today trying to get a hat on a wig, didn't I? My little air hostess hat, I don't think is going to go on a wig. Although I've looked at pictures of Pam Am, and she has them just like perched on her big wigs, but. I just don't want to crush my wig.
No, no.
That's my main worry.
I said he doesn't really need to wear one.
So I might not be in one. I might be just a bit slaggy.
But, I mean, Rebecca Bramley, do you wear your hat while working? Do you have a hat?
Well, they do wear their hats. But I think it's just like through the airport, waiting outside the plane. Once they're on, hats and little jackets come off pretty quick. Unless maybe you wear them to greet people onto the plane. But as soon as people are sat down, those hats
they
are
definitely
off.
Come off when they're serving, don't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, well, little tabards pop on then.
And we have tabards.
We might be popping tabards on to feed people halfway through. I did enjoy Liverpool, Thomas. It's where I grew up, so it was lovely to go back there. Feed Me Seymour says, walk through the crowd with a drinks trolley halfway through. Well, Feed Me Seymour, we will be doing... the air hostesses again in June the 30th here in Scarborough, when we have another House of Games afternoon, and come and see them then, because that's in a much bigger venue, so we'll be able to get the trolley.
It'll be a different show, completely different show.
Yeah,
because our quizzes are different from the bingo shows, aren't they?
Mm.
Well, the bingo shows aren't really bingo. Well, the bingo, but they're more games now, aren't they?
Yeah, they're bits of games, bit of bingo, prizes galore. It's just daft. It's daft, good fun. People who come who love it. People who come love it, leave loving it, don't they?
Yeah.
So if you've never been to one and you're scared about coming to it because you think we're going to pick on you, just come.
Don't be scared.
Come anyway.
And if you win a game and you get up and play a game, everybody's such a lovely supporting crowd, aren't they?
Yeah. Those of you who don't shout out when you're going to win because you're scared we're going to do something. Yeah, we've got to work out that if we do things when people win, maybe we won't anymore, but we will get you up and have fun with you.
We try and allocate games that
we have
suits.
Loads of games in our heads, and we work out who's going to be best for
and
what
game.
And
if you win a game and we don't think, you know, putting your willy on your head is suitable, we won't do that, will we?
Alex Johnson says, surely you guys must have watched The Love Boat on Sunday evenings. Do you know what, Alex? I didn't. Like, I've watched The Love Boat now as an old gay queen. But as a kid, I just didn't get it.
I didn't get it.
It was like, I didn't get that there was laughter. It was like watching Heart to Heart, but with like canned laughter. I just didn't get it. I didn't understand because the credits made it look like it was going to be Heart to Heart. And then there was like canned laughter. And then there were people that I didn't recognise.
Yeah.
I just didn't get it. But I love it
nowadays. It's iconic. We even did one. We did a version, didn't we?
We did. We've done our version of the Love Boat. If you never watched it, give it a search because it's funny because we do loads of celebrities that should be on the Love Boat. Mika Magic is going to be at the quiz on Friday and says she wants a special plate to eat her mid-afternoon cake off. They can't be eaten off, can they?
Huh?
They can't eat off the plates, can you?
No. Don't eat off the plates. They'll poison you. They're for decorative purposes only. And I've had to change the wording because some people keep winning the
yeah, so there are different words now for the winners and the losers.
They're still offensive, but...
Darren says they will try, Mr. and Mrs. Bramley will try and come up in June. And if they do, Mrs. B will actually come in our hostess ensemble full.
She will look
in
amazing.
Her work outfit.
She can help us do the...
She can help us hand out the nuts.
Yeah.
Although we don't have peanuts, no, in case someone has an allergy. Alex Johnson, I preferred Highway to Heaven. Was that the one where it was an angel?
Yeah, that was him from Little House on the Prairie, wasn't it?
Wasn't he an angel?
Yeah. With that fella from Murder, She Wrote and Happy Days.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Paul says, would we ever consider doing a full version of Flying the Flag? We will be in June. It'll most probably be the closing song. Though I've got my outfit sorted for the second half now, isn't it?
I'm not going to tell you what it is. They arrived the day, and it was only 25 quid, and it's amazing.
Yeah.
But being a seamstress myself...
Alan's going to try
I can most probably make my own.
Make one better.
Because I've looked, but nobody has made one for a big girl like me.
Tracy and Tushy Rushworth say it's Michael Landon in Halfway to Heaven. And Thomas Corrigan says Chuckle Vision was set in 1987.
It was, Thomas, you're right.
It was Chuckle Vision on in 1987?
Yeah, they've been on for years, Chuckle Vision.
Do you remember they were dogs beforehand?
No.
The Chuckle Hounds?
No.
Before they were the Chuckle Vision brothers, they were the Chuckle Hounds. And they were like in like Cogsy and Sprinks outfits.
Really?
They were two dogs.
Wow.
I think I've not made that up.
And you know the man who goes, he is always telling them off. That's their other brother, isn't it?
Yeah, there's another chuckle, yeah. Femi Seymour says, remember a nut show in the 90s called The High Life? We're living the high life. We're flying it well. I loved it. I love it. What's up with your push on a spottle? Alex Johnson says, I love Liverpool so much. I'm only down the road in Ormskirk.
Thomas Corrigan says he loves Liverpool.
Alex, I know Ormskirk like the back of my hand.
Ormskirk.
I had lots of friends who lived in Orton. Oh, we should have met up. There were a few of you that said you'd have liked to bump into me in Liverpool. Can you imagine if people had spotted me in Liverpool, how much my friends would have been amazed?
I when I go and visit with Jamie up north, we've sort of been walking down the street and we'll always say, well, if it isn't Jamie Maudsley, because obviously Maudsley is his real name. I haven't seen you in years, Jamie Maudsley.
First Age Comics, Lucy says, there were about five chuckles.
Oh, were they?
They're like the Nolan sisters, the Chuckle Brothers.
I know one of them was...
Were they all males, or was there a female one like the Jackson 5?
And one of them was on the Indian hotel thing, where the pensioners go...
That was Barry or Paul Chuckle. That was one of the main ones.
Because he's got a really wide leg, hasn't he?
Bobbins Duffer works in Ormskirk.
Ormskirk?
There's so many Ormskirk connections.
And also, Bobbins Duffer, are you near Skelmersdale?
NP spent a crazy New Year's Eve in Ormskirk in 2001.
I did theatre and education in Lancashire.
You might have done theatre and education in Bobbins Duffer's school.
No, I remember going to Liverpool in the morning and it's Preston. And they had a bold Lancashire accent, like Patty Caldwell. Then we travelled just 20 minutes down the road.
Yeah, the accents are mental enough.
I was like, God, I can't believe that in such a short distance the accents
Yeah.
Completely changed.
Apparently, like in the UK, if you go from city to city, you can kind of map the accents. So, like, if you go from, like, Manchester to then to Preston, it's kind of, you get the same accent. You can kind of map the accent apart from Liverpool. And in Liverpool, it just, there's no rules. It suddenly changes. So it's not like any other accent nearby.
Oh, yeah, Bob and Stuff live in Skelmersdale.
Thomas Corrigan...
Is he changing... He has changed his name to Carlos.
Yeah. Thomas Corrigan, master of all things chuckle, says there was also Danny and Mick chuckle.
And also Neil Sandwell says the sister of the chuckles was married to Percy Sugden.
Feed Me Seymour, who's fitted right in. I love Feed Me Seymour. Feed Me Seymour. Are you a he, she or they? Let me know. Feed Me Seymour says, 5 chuckles, to me, to you, to you, to you, to you, to you. Lol. And Joel William Hazeldean would love us to know that Going for Gold started in 1987 and Daphne Fowler, then Hudson, won it.
Well, that's for a weekday, isn't it? Going for Gold. There's no one on a Saturday or Sunday.
The heat is on. The time is right. You've sung that in one of our quizzes, haven't you?
I don't think I've sung. Oh, yeah, I have. Yeah.
When people had to guess what theme tune you were singing.
Yeah.
Oh, loves. Paul McFarlane said, can I be excused? You can, my darling. It is... just gone 9:30, yeah, so I guess it's
rabbited
the end.
On for far too long. Thomas is also saying Ken Dodd's from Liverpool.
Ken Dodd's dad's dog's dead. Ken Dodd's dad's dog's dead. That's a little warm up for the tongue.
Just completely retro. Alan going off on a retro tangent. When Jamie's away, I go on weird YouTube journeys,
rabbit holes.
Oh, and I end up watching all sorts. I found, which I watched, two of these old This Is Your Life episodes. And one was Rod Hull. And it's from 1980. And I thought, I'll watch this in case Carol Lee Scott came on it. And she did. Oh, and she got the most perfect little hairdo. It's like white mist. and I loved it. But I also watched Richard Beckinsdale's. Do you remember him?
Yeah,
from Porridge?
Yeah.
He died ever so young. But it was funny because he's actually got a fag on.
Well, his daughters are dead famous, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah, she came on at the end. It's ever so cute. But he's just smoking a fag during it. I thought, God, I sort of vaguely remember watching programmes in the 70s where people were like being interviewed or just lighting up.
Do you want to tell people what you watched today on YouTube?
Yes, I found a new...
No, not that.
Not Sheila. What did I watch today? I thought you weren't telling anybody.
I wasn't going to, but you can tell them. They can find it if they want to find it.
You need to download it as well. Get it.
I will do.
Now, you know Jamie's Super Sleuth. We call him a Super Sleuth. He was actually, when he was a little boy, about 11, was it?
I was 10.
10. He was on number 73. You know, the kids' programme. I'm sure you all know number 73, but Sunny Toxic and them two people in tuxedos.
They were only on that episode.
Well, Jamie was on it in a Super Sleuth competition. And out of 52,000 kids, 12 kids were chosen to take part in the quiz and the competition. On
the finalists.
On the programme. And only 4 won. And Jamie was one of them. And he went to San Francisco on a 2-week holiday.
Yeah.
And today on YouTube, his episode has been put on.
In crystal clear quality, isn't it? Yeah. It's even got its little time thing at the start. So
Jamie
obviously...
had it like recorded off the telly on an old VHS tape, which I think if we put it in the machine now, would just chew up. But whoever's put it on there has made you a very happy boy.
Will Venus says, we've been watching number 73 today. Peepsovsky says, weren't they on skates in number 73? Yeah, Dawn was on skates. She's now a really famous film director.
And they do a sandwich game, don't they?
The sandwich game with Jimmy Net. So anyway, if you want to find it, it's out there. It's just gone up today.
And it's episode 11 series.
Don't tell them. They'll find it if they want to find it.
Jamie's so cute, isn't it? He's not in it a lot, but if you go through...
Oh, you'll find it. The thumbnail is Toya. You'll find it.
And he's so cute because he gets interviewed and he goes, that's what comes up.
I get nervous. I'd just been told I'd won a trip to America, which I'd been trying to win for like 4 months because it had been a long competition.
And I said, Jamie, why are you shy when she talks to you? And he said, well, she said the wrong thing. She was meant to say blah, 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 blah. And she came out with nah, 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 nah. So So therefore, I was thrown.
Yeah, so we were meant to be asked what we're looking forward to in San Francisco, and my like response was, I'm looking forward to being trapped in Alcatraz. Like, and worked it out. So if I won, I was ready for that. And then she sort of says, what's Liverpool like? And can you tell us about Liverpool? And what are you going to tell Americans about Liverpool? And I got dead nervous.
And then she went, can you say something in a Liverpool accent? And Jamie, being from Formby, doesn't have a Scouse accent. So he's like...
I get nervous.
No, sweetheart.
I don't say sweetheart.
You can't do that.
To Sandy Toksvig.
So will you actually put on
I'll download it.
No, but will you put the link on?
Yeah, let's see if anyone can... So Jason, can you find the link for number 73? I think it's Series 5, Episode 11.
I know, but if they put it on here, it'll disappear, won't it?
I'll put the link. I'll share the link.
You're so cute. So you've got to sort of... You know, I watched the old episode. It's quite fun. But you can sort of fast forward it, and then whenever it's the competition bit, you can sort of see him working. Away.
And then I get picked up and put in front of Jimmy Nail to dance in the cellar. But actually, you can't really watch it on
you
the
You didn't
thing.
Go in front of him, you're behind him.
I go in the middle, like by a...
Yeah, but when you said, oh, I've danced for Jimmy Nail, I imagine you'd be like in front of him like that. Or, you know, like being like a groupie.
But then a guitarist falls into me. Mm. Anyway, enjoy. Tracy 30 says, I've found it, lol. Enjoy it, Tracy. Have a nice afternoon watching me. Right, what should we end with? Do you want to end with Who Will Buy Again? Or should we
I want to see that again. It was fun.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because we didn't get caught, did we?
No. All right, so we're looking out for the woman in leopard print, but all of them in their little Sunday outfits.
And there's like a big girl on the escalator in lemon.
All right, darlings.
We'll see some of you on Friday.
Yeah, we'll see some of you on Friday.
If not, we'll see you next Wednesday.
Yes.
Have a great week. Have a great weekend. I hope the weather dries up a bit.
See you soon.
And lots of love. Bye.
Bye.
Hello. Highway this week comes from Ipswich, the county town of Suffolk. We start the programme in this shopping centre, the town's newest acquisition. There's a very good reason for that, which I'll tell you about later. But first, watch this. Oh,
Do you want to look at this?
Yeah.
No, I don't think so.
Because I've been...